Hello. So this is a video that's gonna be all about periods. I had a couple people ask me questions about periods in the van after I did my staying clean in the van, and I figured I'm seeing more and more people who have uteruses traveling around in vans, and this is pretty relevant, so I thought I would share my experience about having a uterus, having a period, and being able to like live full-time in a van and not have it be a hassle. Those of you without uteruses, feel free to watch as well. 50% of the population has one and you might learn something. So here we go. This video is gonna cover a few resources that I use in order to make my van life period experience easier, and also how I stay clean in the van without having access to a shower. Okay, so I have a really heavy period. I basically can last anywhere from like 7 to 10 days. I get really bad cramps, I get really nauseous. And so like for me, it's kind of an ordeal once a month for me to have my period. I'm all about low impact and minimalism. About 2 years ago, I switched from using pads and tampons to the Diva Cup and the Thanks panties, which I will show you. Ta-da! Bum-bum! Diva Cup, here we go. I switched to the Diva Cup because it's reusable. I was really trying to move away from cotton plastic products that I'd have to keep buying and storing and throwing away. So with the Diva Cup, it was like 30 bucks one time from REI, and then that's all I've ever purchased, and it takes up like this much space in my van. So I'm not having to like constantly purchase new things, I'm not having to like throw away trash all the time, and I'm not having to like buy new stuff. I use the Diva Cup, I leave it in for 8 or so hours, and then I take it out, dump it in the pit toilet, dump it in a flush toilet, rinse it off if I can, and then put it back in and keep going. I rinse it off in the sink or with a water bottle. Oftentimes I can't actually rinse it off just because of where I am. So I'll just dump it out, shake it off, wipe it with paper towel or toilet paper, and then put it back in and keep going. When I'm in the van, I don't like to dump my Diva Cup down the drain for the same reason that I don't like to dump my pee bucket down the drain. I don't want to be carrying black water. Occasionally, I will rinse it off in the sink, so it's a little bit different. The only problem with the Diva Cup is that it doesn't create a perfect seal for me, and I have a really heavy period, so it actually leaks through a little bit. And I think this is kind of a common problem. What I usually end up doing is using the Diva Cup and then the Thinx panties. I didn't want to start using pads with the Diva Cup because that totally counteracts the purposes of what I bought the Diva Cup for. The Thinx panties were a perfect solution for me. The period panties every single day of my period, and then I also accompany it with the Diva Cup even when I'm sleeping. They look like this. Ta-da! These are them. I fold all my underwear like that. So they're literally just black underwear like that, and they look exactly the same as normal underwear, and they feel exactly the same as normal underwear, except that the crotch part is just a tiny bit thicker. There's like 3 or 4 different types that you can buy. I have like the medium and the heavy ones, just because like on my light days I like to wear the medium ones, and then on my heavy days I have to wear the heavy ones. I got them all in black because black is the only color underwear that I will buy, because I don't see the point in having white or red or light colored underpants. It doesn't make any sense to me. These are a little bit more maintenance than the Diva Cup because obviously they are underwear that are kind of full of blood. So I usually wear them with the Diva Cup, and I can probably get away with wearing them for like 12 to like, sometimes I'll wear them for 2 days if my period's really light that day, but if it's really heavy, I definitely need to change them out when I feel like they're done. And then I usually hang them to dry on the side mirrors of my van. And then at the end of my cycle, I will take all of them that have kind of been just like rinsed and washed by hand, and I'll wash. That's why I hand wash them throughout the middle of my cycle, and then at the very end, I kind of like do the final rinse. And the other thing is, if I'm out of water, which does end up happening, I have a plastic bag that I'll put them in. When I have access to a sink or when I have access to a washer dryer, then I'll take them out and put them in there, and it's totally fine. I've experimented with doing just the Diva Cup and just the Thinx panties, and sometimes it does work, but for me, the combo is really where it's the most useful. Because I can wear just the Thinx panties, but they get too full too quickly. It's a hassle to have to change them out all the time. I wear the Diva Cup and I just empty that out frequently, and then like whatever's not caught by the Diva Cup gets absorbed into the Thinx panties, and then that can last me a little bit longer, typically 12 hours. Since I don't have a shower in the van, I have to kind of stay extra on top of my baby wipe game. you know, you get a little bit dirtier, you're a little bit more grungy. And if I am out and about in an area where I'm not near my home gym where I can just walk in and take a shower every day, I'll pay for an extra shower or so that week. Like, I typically, when I'm out climbing, I shower like once to twice a week, and then maybe if I'm on a period, I'll do like 3 times a week. But you know, it really depends. Sometimes I won't shower for 2 weeks or whatever. So definitely on my period, I try and shower more, so that's something I have to budget for myself. One thing that helps me is the period tracker app, Clue. I typically don't do anything different on my period than other than like Diva Cup, baby wipes, extra showers, but having this little app is awesome because it allows me to kind of project where I'm gonna be, because I can typically look at the month and be like, oh, I'm gonna be here at this time. I kind of know like, oh, there is no shower here in Indian Creek, so I'm gonna have to make extra trips to town, or I'm gonna have to make sure I got extra baby wipes or extra water or whatever. And then I can be like, oh, well, I'm planning on going to town on whatever day that is, January 4th anyway, so I'll just make sure to do my laundry right before my cycle and right after my cycle. But this thing's cool. They're not a sponsor, just so you know. This is just me really liking this product, so I'm just gonna show you what it does. You can enter in the data for today. Like, how heavy was your bleeding? Do you have cramps? How are your emotions? How much sleep did you get? What's your energy like? Collection method, that kind of stuff. Are you craving? I'm always craving chocolate, so I don't know why I didn't put that there. How is your digestion? So basically you can just track all these things, and it's really helpful, and then it kind of, this Clue is getting smarter and it predicts what you're doing, or predicts your next cycle. You can also sync a cycle with someone else, so you can track people's cycles, which I don't know how I feel about that, but you can if you want to. And then you can look at the calendar view and it'll basically just say, it's like, I know on the 4th is probably my next period, so, you know, I'm probably gonna be in Joshua Tree by then, so I should make sure I have done my laundry so that I'm prepared. Yep, that's that. Basically, having a period in the van is just slightly more logistically challenging than having a period not in a van, but it's really not that bad. I really like the Diva Cup and the Thinx Panties combo. It really kind of helps me reduce my waste, not spend that much money, don't have to take up a bunch of space, and it just is a system that really works for me. So yeah, that's everything. If you have any questions, please let me know. You can follow me on Facebook and Instagram at One Chick Travels. You can find me on Twitter at Kaya Says. You can go to my website, onechicktravels.com, and buy anything in this van. And I think that's everything. I will see you guys next time.